Aturnilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swami Nitri Namene Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Vracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacate Shatarine Panchakalpatarubhyasya Kripa Sindhu Vairivacha Patitanam Pavaneyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namah Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gauravabhavana Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So in the scriptures it says that there's no wealth in the three worlds which can repay the debt to the spiritual teacher.
在经典中这样描述的，就是说，在这个三个世界，没有什么能够堪比有一个灵性导师这样的财富，更重要的财富。
So on this day we make a humble attempt to try to express our appreciation for what we receive from the spiritual teacher.
今天我们卑微地讲述一下，我们如何从我们的灵性导师那里去获得。
So Srila Prabhupada is not just my spiritual teacher, but he's the spiritual teacher of all of you. You're all Srila Prabhupada's followers.
圣帕帕德不仅仅是我的灵性导师，他是你们大家所有人的灵性导师。
That's a very important point which we want to always remind devotees in the Krishna consciousness movement that we are all under the one founder Acharya.
这是一个非常重要的要点，我们希望所有的奉献者都记住，我们都是在我们的创办灵性导师之下。
In the early days of the movement, one devotee was putting some sign up and he just put Acharya Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. And Srila Prabhupada saw it, he was very displeased. He said, there will be many Acharyas. I am not just the Acharya, I am the founder Acharya.
在早期的时候，有一些追随者，他做了一些这个标记，或者说一个牌子，然后这个上面牌子有这个 Bhaktivedanta。 有这个我们的创办灵性导师 A.C. Bhaktivedanta， 然后圣帕帕德当时有点不高兴，他说：“我，对，以后会有很多的Acharya，我只是创办灵性导师。”
So as the movement grows over the years, we are seeing more and more centers, big temples like this one, and more devotees.
随着这个时间推往后面推进，我们会发现有越来越多的中心，以及这样的庙宇，还有越来越多的奉献者，就像这里这样。
I came into the Krishna consciousness movement in 1971 in the London, where we had a center and we had the only deity. We were the only temple with large size deity.
1971年的时候，我加入 Krishna 之觉，我是在伦敦加入的。当时在伦敦，我们有一个大的一个神像。We
were the only.
我们是唯一的。There
was not temples in India.
那个时候在印度没有庙宇。
And even Los Angeles Temple had not yet acquired the large size Radha and Krishna.
即便在那个时候，洛杉矶的庙宇也没有得到那样的 Radha Krishna 的神像。我们是唯一的获得那么大的神像的一个地方。
It was personally arranged for Srila Prabhupada to bring Radha and Landanishwara into the London Temple.
这是圣帕帕德特别准备的，为伦敦庙宇准备的 Radha 和 Krishna 的这个神像。
So when I joined the Krishna Consciousness Movement, I did not think I was joining really.An international organization with many centers and many members.
当时我加入 Krishna 知觉的时候，我当时并没有感觉到我是加入了一个国际 Krishna 知觉协会，那里有很，当时我并没有觉悟到这个世界上有这么多的庙宇。
I was listening to Krishna Kshetra Swami speak when he was at theRadha Deshmelos in Belgium, and he was speaking about his early years as a devotee.
我聆听到就是Krishna Chaitanya Maharaj 在比利时的这个 Radha Desh 讲述了他早期的一些故事。
Radha Desh in Belgium.
Yeah, 在比利时的这个 Radha Desh.
So he was telling how.In the early days, he would walk up and down the streets of Amsterdam with the other devotees, and they would chant a particular tune of the Hare Krishna mantra.
当时，Krishna Chaitanya Maharaj 在阿姆斯特丹和一些奉献者唱诵一些特别的曲调。
That was our activity in the Krishna consciousness movement. That was how we were known.All over the world, that our devotees would go out every day and do sankirtan.
这就是我们当时的活动。我们的奉献者当时就到外面去做 sankirtan 的运动。
We would be seen on the streets every day.
我们会在街上每一天都唱诵。
Even in, like we heard Mahatma Prabhu was speaking about Canada.England, these are not very warm places. You don't get a lot of sunshine there.
就像马哈顿帕布今天早上提到了加拿大，还有我们的这个伦敦，那里是一个不是特别温暖的地方，没有特别多的阳光。
But the devotees were so enthusiastic that we would go out every day and we would try our best to distribute literature.
但是奉献者都非常非常的热情，每一天都到外面去做 Sankirtan 运动，派发这个我们的文献。
And of course, our purpose was often misunderstood.
当然，我们的运动有时候被误解。
People thought we're just trying to make money.
有些时候人们会认为我们只是为了赚钱。
But we were not.Concerned with just making money. There were so many other ways, so many other things we could do if we just wanted to get money.
但其实这是一种误解。如果我们想赚钱的话，我们可以有很多事情去做。
But we chose to chant the Hare Krishna mantra and to distribute our literature to people.
我们只是唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra， 然后把书派发给别人。
It gave us an opportunity to talk about Krishna to people.
这给予我们一个机会去给人们去讲述有关于 Krishna 的话题。
This is how we were trained to become devotees. We were trained to preach Krishna consciousness, and our training began on Sankirtan.
这也是我们当时被训练如何去训练成为一个奉献者，就是加入到 Sankirtan 之中。
So I was impressed when I first came to visit the temple in London. I was impressed to see the devotees how they were having classes every morning and every evening.
当我被介绍到去我们的庙宇之后，我当时非常有兴趣于我们的奉献者在讲述课程。
And I would see teenage men sit and give class.From the script Bhagavad Gita, they would lecture every evening. I was impressed. I thought this is very surprising.
我看到那些精进的人会每一天早上讲述圣典博伽瓦谈课，然后坐在那个座位上看到他们讲这个课，我当时非印象非常的深刻。
This was our program in the Krishna Consciousness Movement, and this program we want to encourage all of you to remind you that it should continue.
这就是我们运动的核心核心活动的一个部分，我也希望能够提醒到大家，这个东西呢，这个活动阅读是能够继续下去。
We get devotees there, they get a group of people together, and they chant Hare Krishna together, and then they eat prasadam, but they don't discuss the philosophy.
有一些朋友，他们去得到一些人，然后呢？就是发展的一些人，发展的一些人呢，在一起 kirtan， 然后吃普沙的，但是他们并不讲哲学。
So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he was our pioneer, and he used to travel to different villages, and everywhere he went, the program would be the same: a little kirtan, a lecture, and prasadam.
我们的先锋，我们的圣巴图诺塔库尔，他以前也到处去旅行传播，但是他去每一个地方，所有的活动都是一样的，一些哲学，一些普沙的，一些 kirtan。
And Srila Prabhupada had the same program, living in the temple every morning must be class, every evening must be class.
圣帕帕德给我们的这个庙宇也是这样的同样的活动，我们如果住在庙宇的话，每天早上有课，晚上同样也有课。
And devotees sometimes of course some devotees think, oh you know he, I've heard his classes before, I know everything he's saying, I don't want to hear.
有一些奉献者可能会觉得，哦，这个课我以前听过，我不想再重复听这个课了，我也不想再去参加。
But Srila Prabhupada would say, if you know everything, why don't you give the class?
那圣帕帕德就会对这样的问题进行回答，如果你既然知道这样的课，那为什么你不能去讲课呢？
And you can go and ask questions so that they can understand more.
你可以去听课，然后给予提出问题，这样你可以理解的更多。
So Srila Prabhupada was always concerned with the education of the devotees.
圣帕帕德总是非常关心奉献者的教育。
That he wanted the devotees should learn this philosophy nicely.
他希望奉献者能够很好地学习这门知识哲学。
And Srila Prabhupada took so much trouble to write the books, to write the purport so elaborately.Just so that we could hear more from him.
圣帕帕德花了很多的心血去写这些书籍，让他花了很多的心血去写这些书籍，就是为了让我们能够阅读他们。
We personally asked Prabhupada about hearing, and we asked, is it necessary we have to hear aloud, or can we just read?Prabhupada said, yeah, you can just read, that is also hearing.
我们也亲自问过圣帕帕德这个问题，我们到底是应该大声的去大的这个聆听呢，还是说只是可以小，就是自己去默默的阅读？圣帕帕德说你可以阅读。
But when we read Srila Prabhupada's purports, Prabhupada points out that even better than just reading is that youExplain what you've read and you discuss what you've been reading.
圣帕帕德在这个也提到另外一个观点，就是说比你单独的阅读更好的是和人们一起去讨论，去阐释你读到的这些内容。
So in this way Prabhupada was encouraging all of us to get a good basis in Krishna consciousness through studying his books.
就这样，圣帕帕德希望我们通过以阅读的方式，通过阅读他的书籍的方式，能为我们的 Krishna 知觉打下一个很好的基础。
So I was attracted to the Krishna consciousness movement. First of all, reading Prabhupada's book, I had, as Mahatma Prabhu was describing this morning, in the 1960s and 70s, young people were very inclined towards spirituality.
我描述了自己是如何被 Krishna 知觉的这种知识还有这种哲学吸引的。马哈特帕布也讲述了在1960年和70年代的时候，当时的人们是非常被这种灵性的氛围和文化所吸引。
I have been reading different books, different spiritual teachers, but I had not appreciated. I didn't like them. I didn't understand them.
当时我也阅读了一些不同的老师所写的这样一些文章，但是我当时并不是很欣赏。
Sometimes people write books and nobody can understand them.
有时候人们写一些书，他写的这个书没有人能够理解这本书到底写的什么。
There are some people like that in India. The guru writes books and the disciples read the books.To try to understand what the guru is saying.
有时候在印度就发生这样的事情，这个咕噜写一本书，然后呢，门徒专门为咕噜的这本书去写一本书，去阐释他咕噜写的书的内容的含义。
But when I read Prabhupada's book, I was surprised that everything was so clear. The meaning was very clear.
当我阅读圣帕帕德的书籍的时候，我非常的惊讶于圣帕帕德的书籍竟然这么的清晰。
And I thought I have to find out more.
当时我就想，我应该探索更多。
And when I went to the Krishna Conscious Center, I was impressed how the devotees were living simply.
当时我去到这个庙宇里面的时候，我就发现。竟然发现奉献者竟然生活得这么的简朴。
And how they were taking time to sit every day to discuss and to explain the teachings of Krishna consciousness.
我也惊讶于奉献者每天竟然就是说会花如此多的时间去学习和了解 Krishna 的教导。
The devotees were not very old. Most of them were teenagers.
奉献者都当时的奉献者都不是年纪大的人，他们都是年轻人。
And most of them were not much educated either.
甚至有很多人，他们的受教育程度并不很高。
Sometimes when they try to read books, they would have difficulty to pronounce some of the words.
他们有些时候读书的时候，甚至不能够发正确的发音。
But they were very sincere.
但是他们非常的真诚
and they love to chant the Maha Mantra.
他们非常热爱唱诵 Hare Krishna Maha Mantra.
And every day we would go out and chant.
而且每一天我们都到外面去唱诵
Srila Prabhupada wrote in one letter to devotee, Our temples are not a place for just eating and sleeping.
圣帕帕德在一封信中是这么写到的：我们的庙宇不仅仅是给你们提供吃饭和睡觉的地方。
They're a base for the armies to go out and fight Maya.
这个是给我们的军队去给 Maya 作战的地方。
So I was brought into Krishna consciousness in that mood that, you know, we were fighting a war.
我就成长于这样的一种 Krishna 知觉的这些心态之中，我们其实在参加一场战斗，一场战争。
We're fighting a war against the materialism.
我们在与物质主义做斗争。
And we're fighting against atheism and all kinds of mistaken philosophies.
我们在与无神论做斗争，我们在与所有的这些被误导的这些哲学做斗争。
And we would be very bold to go out and speak about Krishna consciousness.
我们也非常勇敢地想出去去讲述 Krishna 知觉的哲学。
We would go into big universities and we would speak about Krishna consciousness.
我们会去大学里面讲述 Krishna 知觉。
We would go to, sometimes they would have these pop concerts.And we were famous at that time because we had recordings of the Hare Krishna mantra. So they would invite us to come and chant on the stage.
我们也会去一些流行的这些音乐会，然后呢， 我们也有我们的非常录音录得非常好的这些磁带，所以他们也会邀请我们去一些非常棒的舞台上去演唱诵 Hare Krishna。
And at that time we would also speak about the Krishna conscious philosophy。
在这样的舞台上我们同样能讲出 Krishna 知觉的哲学。
And we would show Prabhupada's books and explain about Srila Prabhupada。
我们还会向他们展示 Krishna Krishna 的 book， 就是我们哲学的这些书籍，然后讲述圣帕帕的教导。
We were all very proud of Srila Prabhupada。
我们对帕帕帕的因此为傲。
Srila Prabhupada had given us so much。
圣帕帕的给予我们太多。
And we wanted to give everything for Srila Prabhupada。
我们也想把圣帕帕的给予我们的一切都给予出去。
And we did。We gave everything. There was no question of salary for anybody.
我们也想把我们的一切给予这个圣帕帕德。在那个时候，我们所有人都没有工资。
Everybody was working for Krishna.
每一个人都在为 Krishna 而工作。
And we were happy to work for Krishna.
我们也非常乐意为 Krishna 而工作。
And we had Srila Prabhupada as our leader.
圣帕帕德就是我们的领导。
And he was our very trusted leader.
他是我们非常值得信任的领导。
I remember seeing in London, we had no Bhaktivedanta Manor, and this was before the time of the Bhaktivedanta Manor, and we were all living in a small rented house.
我记得在伦敦，那个时候还没有 Bhaktivedanta Manor，这是在 Bhaktivedanta Manor 之前的故事，我们当时是租的房子。
So we had one room for Srila Prabhupada, which we kept for Srila Prabhupada.
当时我们有一间房是专门为圣帕帕德准备的。
It was directly, the temple was on the ground floor, and Prabhupada's room was just one flight up from the temple.
当时一楼是庙宇，然后呢，那个圣帕帕德的房间离庙宇非常近。
And there was also the toilet, which washroom, which was there, specially just for Srila Prabhupada.
而且还有一个单独的卫生间是特别给圣帕帕德留的。
So the devotee came. We were trying to develop the Sankirtan in London, and we were not doing very well. So the devotees in USA were doing much better. So it was.Some devotees from the U.S. were invited to come to England and train us up.
当时我们想做 Sankirtan 运动，但是呢，我们当时并没有像美国的那些奉献者做的那么好。于是我们就邀请了一些美国的奉献者来到伦敦。
People in England are not as wealthy as people in America usually.
通常，英国的奉献者没有美国的奉献者当时那么富裕。
There's a higher standard of living.
当时在美国的这个生活标准要比英国的要高一些。
So our Sankirtan collection was not very much, but the devotees came from America, and they came and you know they were training. So, but the one devotee, he saw Prabhupada's room, and he said, "Oh no, no!" He said, "This is not good enough for Prabhupada."
当时 Sankirtan 运动，我们的伦敦的 Sankirtan。这个运动没有得到特别多的捐款，但是呢，这个美国来的奉献者来看到圣帕帕德的房间之后，他就说：“哦，不不不，这个标准给予圣帕帕德这个房间太低了。”
He said, so he wrote a letter to Srila Prabhupada. He said, Srila Prabhupada, he said, you know, that room is not very good for you. I don't think it's good enough. He said, when you come next time to England.We'll rent you a suite in the hotel.
当这个奉献者看到了这个情况之后，他就给圣帕帕德写一封信，他就说，这我发现伦敦这个地方的这个房间并不太适合你。当你下一次来到伦敦的时候，我们会为你租一个酒店。
But Srila Prabhupada wrote back and said, I like that room.I don't want to stay in any hotel. I like to stay in the temple.
圣帕帕德就给那个奉献者回信说，我不喜欢宾馆，我喜欢那个房间，我不喜欢任何的宾馆，我就要住在那个房间。
So we devotees, of course, we were ecstatic. We loved that mood of Srila Prabhupada that he liked to be with us.
奉献者听到这个的时候都特别的狂喜，特别喜欢圣帕巴的这种心态，特别喜欢圣帕巴的想要跟奉献者在一起的这种心态。
And he was always training us up. Every morning, he liked to go for a walk. During our japa period, he would like to go out for a walk. And if you were fortunate, you got to go with him.
圣帕巴德当时也训练我们每天早上跟着他一起去加帕清晨散步。如果你非常幸运的话，你也可以被挑选出跟他一起去散步。Not
everybody got to go with Prabhupada, but you know, some few devotees.
不是每一个人都能够跟帕帕一起去散步，只有一些少数的奉献者。So
when we would walk, Prabhupada would sometimes talk, and then he would be quizzing. He would say, "What is that sloka?"
当圣帕帕德跟我们跟圣帕帕德一起去散步的时候，圣帕帕德有时就会问我们那个世界是什么。
He would want to know. He would want to know. Are we learning the philosophy? He would be testing us.
他在检测我们。他有时候会检测我们到底是不是在学习，认真学习我们的哲学。
And somebody sang a song one morning. A devotee sang a song. Prabhupada said to him, "Do you know the meaning?"
有些时候，奉献者会早上的时候唱一个歌曲，然后圣帕巴德就问他：“你知道你唱的这首歌的含义吗？”
If you don't know the meaning, there's no benefit.
如果你并不知道这首歌的含义，没有什么用处。
So like this, Srila Prabhupada was constantly training us and checking on us.
这是圣帕帕德一直会不断地去检验我们，去考验我们。
He was very concerned to see the devotees shave their heads.
他也非常关心奉献者是不是把头发都剃光了。
The men that he expected all the men to have shaved heads.
他希望所有的奉献者都能光头，男奉献者都光头。
Yeah. And the ladies were expected to dress in saris.
他希望奉献者，女奉献者，妈的姐们都穿纱人。
And their hair would be tied up.
而且头发应该盘起来。
Or tied back.
应该。 就是扎起来，扎到后面去。
It would not be hanging over the shoulders.
不要就是说，就是吊在前面的肩上。
And they would put sari over their head.
然后用纱蕊盖住头发。
And this is how people are supposed to wear the Vedic dress, the sari.
这就是伟大的传统，人们如何穿纱蕊的。
And Prabhupada had all the men shave the head.
怕不怕让当时的男奉献者全部都剃光头
？You like to see devotees with cool heads.
他希望奉献者的头脑都清醒。
So you can see modern times how things have changed.
你可以看到现在的这个情况，我们发生了多大的改变
？How people, you know, they're not so. In the same mood as in Srila Prabhupada's days.
所以我们现在的这个心态跟圣帕帕德那个时代的时候的心态是有很大的不同的。
Young men, they don't like to shave their heads.
我们的年轻人并不喜欢剃头。
And the women often don't tie up their hair or tie their hair. They have it hanging over their shoulders.
还有我们的女士也并不喜欢把头发扎起来，都会过肩。
They don't even like to wear saris sometimes.
他们也不喜欢穿纱人，有些时候。
But Srila Prabhupada had these standards. He liked to do things his way.
但是圣帕帕德那个时候就有这些标准，他喜欢按照他的标准去行事。
You like to see the devotees that there has to be some discipline in the temple.
他希望奉献者在庙宇里面的时候有一些规则。And
that was why he gave so much position to Tamal Krishna Goswami, because he was very good in disciplining
这也是圣帕帕德为什么给予塔姆纳克什纳高斯瓦米这么高的位置，因为塔姆纳克什纳高斯瓦米非常的遵守规则。
He said, Kamal Krishna Goswami said to me one time, he said, now I know why Prabhupada sent me to China.
Kamala Krishna Goswami 有一次这么跟我说，他说现在我终于知道圣帕帕德为什么会把我派到中国来了。
He was, you know, at first he was a little bit, he thought, oh, it's a punishment. But he said, now I know why Prabhupada sent me to China. He said, because in China,People know the meaning of discipline.
他说：“现在我终于知道圣帕帕德为什么带要把我派到中国来，因为在中国人们知道什么叫做规则。”
Yes, China, there's a lot of discipline.
因为在中国有特别多的规范规则。
Just try going into the train station.
你如果去那个火车站的话。
They'll check your ticket three times.
他会检查你的票，检查三次。
Before you even get near the train.
即便你已经马上很着急要上火车了。
And you get on the train, every carriage there's an attendant checking everything.
你即便上了火车之后，每一个乘客有时候也会被检查一次票。
I have a lot of experience in China train.
我在这个坐中国火车上有特别多的经验体验。
So, anyway, that was Kamal Krishna. Everybody laughed when I said that. They all thought, you know, they thought Kamal Krishna is just using this as an excuse.
当我来分享 Kamal Krishna Goswami 说的这个话的时候，当时在场的所有人都笑了，因为
But actually, I think Kamal Krishna Maharaj, he actually believed that Prabhupada did want him. He thought he would be good in China.
Kamala Krishna Goswami 知道圣帕帕德把他派到中国。Kamala Krishna Goswami 知道他如果在中国的话会非常的好。
And he was very close to Prabhupada. He was the intimate servant of Srila Prabhupada.
他对于圣帕帕德来说非常亲近，他是非常亲近的这个仆人。
So I learned more about Prabhupada from him than I did from Prabhupada.
我是从他那里学习了很多，了解到了很多关于圣帕帕德。
I'm just an ordinary devotee. I'm not a special devotee. So I never got very close to Prabhupada.
我只是一个非常普通的奉献者，一个非常普通的奉献者。我并没有很多的机会去接近圣帕帕德。
When I was in Prabhupada's presence, I would just be quiet and hear him.
当我看到圣帕帕德在我面前临在的时候，我只是沉默去聆听。
If I had, well, sometimes I got to go on a walk with Prabhupada, I would just let Prabhupada talk.
当我和圣帕帕德一起去散步的时候，得到这个机会跟圣帕帕德一起去散步的时候。我只是希望能够聆听圣帕帕德。
It was my opportunity to hear directly from Prabhupada.
这是我的机会，能够直接去聆听圣帕帕德的机会。
So, certainly, if Srila Prabhupada was here today, I'd have many questions for him.
当然，如果在今天的话，我如果还能见到圣帕帕的话，我肯定会有很多的问题给予圣帕帕德。
There's many things, but In the beginning, you know, everything is new, you don't worry too much, but later on, as you go on, you have more and more questions, more and more things.
在开始的时候，我们可能并没有什么问题，因为我们都太新了，什么都不太清楚。但是呢，随着越来越时间休息的越来越长，我们就会有很多关心的这些问题。
Srila Prabhupada could be very direct in answering sometimes questions.
圣帕帕德对于回答一些问题会非常的直接。
Bhakti Vikas Swami, my good friend, he told me how when he got second initiation from Srila Prabhupada, he had a lot of questions ready to ask Prabhupada.
我的好朋友神兄弟 Bhakti Vikas Swami, 他二次起义的时候，他当时准备了很多的问题给予圣帕帕德。
He got the first question out, and then Prabhupada said, You chant in the morning, you chant at noon, you chant at night. Is it clear?
然后圣帕帕达就是说，你早上也唱诵，中午也唱诵，晚上也唱诵，听清楚了没？
So back again. Yes, yes, wrong. After your basin season went out, that was the end of it.
当邦提维卡什斯瓦米听到这个帕帕的这么说的时候，是的，是的，帕帕。然后他顶拜之后就走了。
You know, Prabhupada would make it very clear what he wanted. If he wanted to talk about something, if he didn't want to talk, he'd let you know.
圣帕帕德对于很多事情都非常非常清晰，他如果他想讲述的话他就会讲述，他不想讲述的话他就也会让你清楚的知道。
You know, when Prabhupada first came to London, the devotees arranged public lectures for Srila Prabhupada, and one of the places was Conway Hall, which is quite a nice place, quite a big building in London, and they had a number of lectures there.
当圣帕帕德被邀请去到伦敦的时候，奉献者邀请他去到一个非常不错的地方去进行一个公开的演讲。
The hall was called Conway Hall.
那个大楼叫做 Conway Hall.
If you read the introduction of Sri Ishopanishad, the introductory lecture, Introduction to the Vedas, that lecture was given in Conway Hall.
如果我们阅读至尊奥义书的这个前面的序言的话，那个讲述那个就是这篇文章就是在空威这个大楼的地方被讲述的。
So Prabhupada, you know, he gave the lectures at Conway. Other times we would book London has different towns within the city of London. There are different townslike the Kensington and Wimbledon. There are different suburbs of London. And in each suburb, they will have a town hall, a very nice big hall, which is a government place.
在伦敦的附近周围有很多的小镇，每一个镇上都有一个大堂，像一个大的礼堂还是一个礼堂一样的情况。这些地方都非常的不错，都是由政府部门建造的。
We would have Prabhupada go there, give lectures there.
我们也让圣帕帕德去这些地方做讲课。
So it happened one time, one of Prabhupada's very early disciples, he was an Indian man, he lived in London, and he actually was very good man. He was the one who got the land in Vrindavan, the Krishna Balaram land. He was in his doing that we got that land.
有一个圣帕帕德的门徒，他是住在伦敦非常早期的这个门徒，然后他是一个印度人，他也非常有名，他当时得到了 Vrindavan， 我们的 Krishna Balaram 的这一片土地。
So in London, he had his family, his wife and three sons, and they're all devotees, and the sons are still devotees.
他和他的妻子，然后还有他的孩子。都是奉献者
so
他的孩子现在也仍是奉献者。
So the man wanted to install deities in his house. He said, I want you to do a Bhagavat Sapta, and I will arrange the hall, and you can come and give Bhagavat Sapta, and at the same time install the deities.
他想在他家里面设立这个神像，然后希望您给
Bhagavat Sapta.
Bhagavat Sapta.
Sapta means 7 days. You're going to speak on the Bhagavatam for 7 days.
就是说讲述七天的圣典博迦瓦坛。
Right? It's very common in India. They do Bhagavat Saptas. They will speak on Srimad Bhagavatam for 7 days.
这个在印度非常普遍，他们会连续七天讲述圣典博迦瓦坛。
Sukadev Goswami spoke to Maharaj Pariksit for 7 days, so they think we will also speak for 7 days.
Sukadev Goswami 给 Pariksit Maharaj 讲七天，然后呢，当时有很多人也希望这么做，我们来讲一个七天的圣典不加瓦盘。
So this man arranged the program. Prabhupada agreed, and he went there. The first night he came, he gave the lecture, he installed the deities, he went back, and he said, I'm not going there again.
当这个人给圣帕帕德安排了这个七天的圣典博加瓦坛讲课的时候，圣帕帕德同意了。然后呢，圣帕帕德去了之后给了一天的讲课，圣帕帕德回去之后他就说，我再也不要去了。
He said that hall was terrible.
他说这个地方，这个大个礼堂的这个地方简直太糟糕了。
He did not like the hall. It was just an ordinary little grubby place, dirty place, you know.
他说这个礼堂太糟糕了，它只是一个非常普通的，然后还有很多垃圾的一个糟糕的地方。
So Prabhupada was particular about things.
圣帕帕德对一些事情他是很在乎的。
You wanted Prabhupada to go to the program, you know, sometimes he could be particular. If you didn't have the nice hall, the right facility, you wouldn't go.
圣帕帕德对一些事情是有要求的。如果这个地方不是特别的好的话，圣帕帕德可能也不会去。
Well, he went the first night. After that, he turned to his sannyasi disciple and said, "Tomorrow night, you go."
当他去了一天之后，然后返回去，他就转向他的这些sannyasi的门徒，就说：“明天你们去那儿。”
Then you finish the Bhagavad Sutta.
你去完成这个七天的圣典博迦瓦坛的课。
In this way, Prabhupada was making use of his sannyasi disciple.
以这样的方式，圣帕帕德充分的去用他的这些sannyasi的门徒。
Just like sometimes when Prabhupada would give initiation, he'd have one of the sannyasis give the lecture.
有些时候比如说有的时候，圣帕帕德在做这个启迪的时候，他让他的sannyasi的这个门徒讲课。
I remember when Prabhupada would give lecture in Calcutta.He would ask Jayaprataka Swami to translate the lecture to Bengali.
当圣帕帕德在加尔各答做这个讲课的时候，他会让圣加帕达斯瓦米把他的讲课翻译成本高里语言，就是孟加拉语言。
And then he would check how nicely Jayaprataka Swami was learning the local language.
他也会以此方式检视圣加帕达斯瓦米是。到底学当地的语言学得怎么样？
So Prabhupada expected the devotees to, if they live in a country like in India, they're living in India, they should learn the local language, speak the language.
圣帕帕德就是希望住在当地的奉献者，比如说住在印度的奉献者，希望他们能够学习当地的语言，学习印度语。
In China, we have the similar saying.
在中国，我们也这么做。
见人讲人话，见鬼讲鬼话。
见人讲人话，见鬼讲鬼话。
They're all laughing.
If you see the people, you see the people.
Among the people, you speak the language of the people. Among the ghosts.You speak the language of the ghost. Very interesting.
非常有趣。
Okay. So, you know, like that, Prabhupada is training us. What do you want? You know, you're going to preach here, you have to speak the language of the people.
这也是圣帕帕德希望的。如果你想在这个地方去传教的话，传播的话，你应该去学习当地的语言。
So,Prabhupada was very concerned about prasadam. He would always check on the prasadam. Every program, wherever we were distributing prasadam, say, bring me a plate. I want to see what you're distributing.
圣帕帕德也特别特别关心 prasadam. 他每次去做公开的这个活动的时候，他也会去检查奉献者们准备的这个 prasadam. 然后他还会让奉献者给他准备一盘，他想去看一看。你们到底在给人们派发什么样的补偿呢？
It was very important to Srila Prabhupada.
这对于圣帕帕来说也是一件很重要的事情，他会很关心。
It should not be too spicy. It should not be too oily.
这些食物不应该太辣，也不应该太油。
Everything must be very nicely prepared.
一切都应该非常很好的被准备着。
One time we were making samosas in the London temple.
有一次我们在伦敦准备这个萨摩萨。
And each time we got one cook, we'd rush it up to Prabhupada, and Prabhupada would give us his criticism of it.
我们急冲冲的把这个准备好的跑到去呈现给圣帕巴的，圣帕巴的就批评了。
He was saying, "Oh no, this pastry, you've got too much oil or not enough oil."
他说你这个太油了，或者说有可能有一些，或者说太油了。
Oh, the filling, 那边那个馅。The filling that inside of the samosa is not properly cooked.
而且在这个 samosa 里面包的这个馅也不是恰当的被，就是说可能没有被烹饪的很好。
He was very concerned. Sometimes if he saw the puris had not been cooked properly, oh, he would be very upset.
当时有时候圣帕帕的甚至看到一个 puri 一个炸的 puri 没有被很好的被炸出来的话，他也会很失望。
He was very concerned. If devotees cooked some sweet, which was all marzipan and chocolate, he would say, "What is this?"
当圣帕帕德如果看到奉献者去准备一些巧克力做的这些甜点的时候，圣帕帕德说："你这个准备的是什么？"
He said, "I've taught you to make Bengali sweets."
我告诉你们要准备这个孟加拉的甜点。
He said, "Not this." Marzipan, chocolate, all these things. This is your Western concoction.
我让你们准备了孟加拉的甜点，而不是这些西方文化的这些甜点，什么巧克力东西之类的。
In the beginning of our movement like that, we would cook traditional Vedic food.
在早期的时候就是这样，我们会烹饪非常传统的、伟大的。
And people loved it.
人们非常喜欢这些食物。
Even now, sometimes I remember when I first went to Ipoh. You know, Ipoh. There's a town in Malaysia, Ipoh. You know, the city of Ipoh. The devotees there, they are still remembering the first devotees who came there. How they cooked ras malai and malpura for them.
当我之前去那个怡保的时候，当时那里的第一个奉献者，他非常印象的深刻，记得奉献者是教他做这个 rasa malai。
Malpura。
Malpura。
中国人没听过 malpura， 真可惜。你们没有去过 malpura。
Malpura。
Anyway, devotees here, they can make malpura. Very.
我们中国人没有吃过和听过malpura，太不幸了，太可惜了。
I said they're not lucky. They've never tasted malpura. So many things Srila Prabhupada gave us.
所以圣帕帕德给予我们太多的东西。
But we don't want to forget them.
我们不应该忘记他们。
Things like sit properly，
还有恰当的坐好，坐得端正一些。
Devotees don't even know how to sit properly。
奉献者甚至都不知道什么样叫坐得恰当，正确的坐姿。
Right. One devotee told me they got a great benefit from Mahatma Prabhu's japa class because she learned.That I have to sit straight when I chant japa.
有一个奉献者告诉我，他说他从马哈腾帕布那个加帕瑞雀的课程中得到了巨大的帮助。他说，其中有一点就是说，当我们在念诵的时候，我们应该坐直。
Yes.
是的。
That's in Prabhupada's books. If you read Prabhupada's books carefully, you'll see it there.
这也是圣帕帕德所教导的。如果你阅读圣帕帕德的书的话。帕帕德也有关于这个的描述。
And so you would often hear Prabhupada say, "Sit properly."
你也会听到圣帕帕德经常在讲课中也会说，坐得恰当一些，坐好。
Right. So, and then Prabhupada would also talk. We'd be very concerned about eating prasadam. How you eat prasadam, that you use the right hand.To eat prasadam.
圣帕帕德也关心我们吃普沙门。他说，如果你吃普沙门的话，应该用右手。
Sometimes the, if you use two hands, it means you were a meat eater.
如果你用两个手去吃饭的话，代表了你是一个吃肉的人。
So the left hand is for cleaning the body, and the right hand is for chanting and eating prasada.
我们的左手是用来清洁身体的，我们的右手是用来念诵和吃普沙的。
But everywhere I go, I see the Buddhists. They don't know these things. They have to be reminded.
我去到一些地方，我发现有一些奉献者并不知道这些，所以我想提醒一下。
We do have some wonderful temples. I had the opportunity to go to Radha Desh, and it's a magnificent temple.
我得到一些机会去很多的一些庙宇，比如说我去到这个 Radha Desh 比利时的这个庙宇，那简直非常棒。
It's just
金碧辉煌。
It's just indescribable. It's so beautiful. It's so magnificent.The devotees have restored it. It was a very old, dilapidated building, but it has been renovated very nicely, and it's very magnificent.
我简直无法描述这个地方的好。就是说，这个大楼原本是一个非常老的楼，但是奉献者重建和重新装修了之后，这个地方非常非常的漂亮，被装饰的非常的好。
So we hope also this center here will be very nicely developed and improved even more as it, from what it is today.
就像我也希望我们现在的这个庙宇也每一天都发展得更好，就比昨天还要好。
We were hearing Shiva Chaitanya Prabhu say they want to finish the development in the ground floor.
就像西方产业链跑步说的，他们想完成一楼，就是底下一楼的这个工程。
But I think the devotees did a very magnificent job. They decorated the temple very nicely.
奉献者们在这个活动期间也把这个庙宇都装饰得非常的好。
And you can see the deities.
而且你们可以看到这个神像。
I went to Europe.And I was shocked that often the temples they have no flowers.
当我去到欧洲的一些庙宇的时候，我非常惊讶，他们有一些庙宇甚至都没有鲜花。
Flowers, you know, in Switzerland, one flower will cost you €2 or €3.
当我去到这个瑞士的时候，那有一些地方，他们的一朵鲜花相当于要€2。
So things that you know the Just it's difficult for them to get the flowers.
对于他们那个地方的人奉献者来说，非常困难得到得到鲜花。
We can see the natural opulence of Malaysia.
我们可以看
so many flowers.
我们可以看到马来西亚有这种天然的富裕，我们很容易得到这么多的鲜花。
And so many varieties of fruits.
而且有各种各样不同的水果。
And also wonderful kirtans.
还有非常棒的 kirtan，
very expert musicians, the madanga playing, and the harmon, everything. The devotees are becoming more and more expert.
这里的 kirtan， 这里的奉献者 madanga player 都非这个这些鼓手都非常的专业。
We just hope they will also remember sometimes shave the head.
我们也只是希望他们有些时候能够把头剃一剃。
Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
非常感谢大家 ，Hare Krishna。